Good to see you.
I'm telling you, Linda.
Mix up home, please.
Good to see the both of you.
I tell you, I don't know about you, but it's exciting when a couple of women, a couple of gorgeous women are over there getting each other's face ready to fight, you know?
That's never happened before.
What? I know.
Say what you do.
But you know what it is that the two of you look like in the song, that you really cannot stand each other?
That's good acting.
Yeah.
Ooh, I mean, do you feel any of those feelings, like maybe this is really happening while you're doing the song?
I try to make it as real in my mind as I can.
But we can make each other laugh in a heartbeat.
Well, you know, that's the thing. I was going to point this out. I was watching dress rehearsal, okay?
Uh-huh. And you
guys, yeah, and you guys were going through. And they're just looking at you, just giggling like you wouldn't believe doing this song. And I'm saying, that's the worst song in the world to get the giggles on. You know?
Yeah, it really is.
So I guess you get it out of the way during rehearsal so it won't happen when you do the live show.
Oh, boy, when we get on stage on a concert, we're serious.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Hey, is this the first? See, Charlie and I are talking.
Don't look at me like that.
You're scaring Charlie, Reba.
I'm sorry.
But Charlie and I were talking while you were doing the song. We were just asking each other, have any other two females in country music ever done a really strong duet like this before that's been this big? We couldn't think of one. Is this a first?
I think Dolly and Lori Morgan had one out on an album or something that someone told me, and I don't even know the song. But this is a big gamble. It was a huge gamble, but.
What a song, though.
I think it worked out pretty
good. It worked out.
Good job. But thanks. Well, that's nice and certain.
I know Linda's been part of the backup section of your production. How did the two of you get together before that? I mean, how'd you find out about Linda Davis?
Well, when I was pregnant with Shelby, they put me to bed because I was having early contractions. And that was in the latter part of 89. And I was listening to demo tapes all the time because that's about all I could do, getting ready for the next album that I was going to record. And Narva would come in at night and say, well, have you heard any good songs? I said, I don't know, but this one girl singer is just killing me. She is great. And I said, I don't know if the songs are any good or not. And he listened to them. And he fell in love with Linda's voice just like I had. We didn't even know who she was. So he started asking around, finding out who she was. And make a long story short, Narval started managing her. And then when Linda and her last record deal parted, I told Narval, I said, we were getting ready for this year's tour. And I said, won't you ask Linda if she wants to go out on the road with me? And he said, well, okay, I'll ask her. And then when she said yes, I said, now I ask her husband, Lang, if he'd go out with me, too.
He's got a great
voice. I love his singing, Lang Scott. So I got the family package.
Oh, that's
wonderful. Sure did. Well, Linda, what does it mean to you? I'm sure that you can put it into words what Reba's support is doing.
I try to feebly put it into words, but this this lady is so giving, and everything that she says, I just can't believe that she's endorsing me like this. And she went to bat for me with her record company to be a part of this. And I knew they loved me, and I knew they wanted good for me in my career, but I just never dreamed that she would stick her neck out this far.
Well, what's happened as a result of the success of this particular song? Has there been a change in career or anything like that for you?
Yes, there has.
Really?
Thank goodness and thank you. There is a new record deal in the works with Arista Records. Tim DuBois.
Tim DuBois and his out there. Okay.
I don't know if anybody can see, but Reba's tearing up a little bit here.
She does this to me. Whether she's talking or she's singing, she makes me cry. And I went to her first, what was it?
A showcase.
A showcase, thanks. Went to the showcase and I cried through the whole thing. I don't care if she sang a sad song or a happy song. She does that to me. She's the only female that's ever made me cry.
Well, you two are wonderful. As a matter of fact, would you come back tomorrow night and sing that again?
Now, do you want us to giggle or get serious when we sing?
Try the giggling one tomorrow night. I want to see what happens on that one. But no, this was really magic and really wonderful for us, and we certainly appreciate you doing that.
Good luck to y'all.
Well, thank you.
Happy to be here.
Well, aren't we a bunch of blessed people sitting here tonight?
I'm happy.
Isn't that the truth?
I'm happy.
Look who we've got sitting over here. Okay. Well, we're gonna see you guys back in a minute.
Yeah.
We'll take a break. We'll be back with more of everything.